The State Minister for Internal Affairs, General David Muhoozi, has issued a 1 month and three phases for settling disputes arising from the herdsmen, commonly known as Balalo, who are illegally occupying some areas of the Greater Northern Uganda.
We are starting with those on government land, those in Gotapoyo. Those, if there are any in Aswa, not permitted there by government, and then Maruzi, which is in Lango. And then phase two, we shall move on those that moved stock illegally and are on communal lands.
General David Muhoozi wants the operation to be as smooth and legal as possible.
Can we have 1 month as the upward limit and then do 14 days as the time? And for government, I don't see the difficulty. If you know the people in a government ranch, you use the 2 days to call them. When you go back, those people, you give them notice. Then the plan will take, I think, also 3 days. By Monday should be out. Then the 9 days can be execution, so that we are done, and then we go to phase two.
The operation will first focus on removing all illegal occupants of the government ranches like Achua and Maruzi. However, the Ministry of Agriculture is guiding the security and local government leaders not to allow the herdsmen to scatter their animals, as this will spread diseases.
Then the sub-county authorities, the other side, who actually know the place properly, are supposed to guide the DVO that where this young man or this young lady is bringing animals, really, one, the land is there, two, the grass is enough, three, the area is fenced, four, the area has water, five, disease control infrastructure is in place.
This was not well received by some of the local leaders.
I want to respectfully depart and disagree. Now, when it comes to the diseases, I think when they were coming, they did not follow the procedures. What if when they were coming, they already brought the disease here? So we need to also put that into consideration, because otherwise we shall invent and import technicalities that may hamper this execution.
Because Arua, I think, is one of the biggest markets for meat. And many of the animals, I have seen the papers for these people who are carrying the animals, they take it for slaughter. And I have some politicians in my district who do not want to see any lorry crossing the district.
With the Gulu District LOC 5 chairperson, Opio Christopher Ateker, emphasizing that people will soon revolt as they are unable to eat meat.
We put the district veterinary officer and the vet officers at the various sub-counties at the forefront, because they are the technical persons. But who knows, in the event where they conduct certain verifications in our absence, who knows, there could be some friends also among whom they can shelve and write things which are not proper. The president cannot continuously direct. At the end, the people who are directed are the ones who are going to be taken serious. And in general, we want to back you up this time that you succeed.
The Minister of State for Labour, Charles Okello Engola, cautioned the district leaders against being harsh towards the herdsmen.
We are going to work together in the district, sit down as a district and come up with a place where the animals are going to assemble together, and then you call these commanders, call these real rebellious and what, to show them that this is where our animals are going to assemble. The work starts now.
The Ministry of Agriculture, Animal Industry and Fisheries has also identified the misuse of animals' movement permits to stock farms as a stumbling block. And Operation Wealth Creation urges an agency to take lead and solve the problems nationally.
Be also part of the operational orders, so that we are able to coordinate when these people are successfully out of this region, then we have handed them over to some authority until they are finally to their destination. I think this one we must take it into consideration.
The current operation comes from President Yoweri Museveni's directive in October 2017 for all illegal herdsmen to evacuate northern Uganda. Reporting for the news, I am Joseph Omagor in Gulu City.